for mustache. Or scribe stuff from Xindi Anna Moans. Yes! Elmo and I are teaming up. We're heading back to the bronze to get supplies and rest. And in the case of Signor Mo, probably more clams. As I was heading to my room, I saw a few of my fellow adventurers sitting around the fire in the bronze. I could hear they were all trying to brag who went the furthest, who killed the most goblins, who banged two ladies in a hot tub while drinking out of a hill giant's skull. I'm looking at you, Jorlane. Who had relations with an owlbear. Oh my gods, the claws on those things alone. Or a hill giantess. Do you have sex with her or just walk inside? I mean, really. And who played the most rounds of Guess Who's Mouth or Hide the Sausage with Tony Baloney? I was not in the mood for that tonight. Besides, we all know I put all of them to shame. I am Xindi Anna Moans, after all. And whoa! Did I hear about how Calcath wailed D-Day in the nuts with that rock? Whoa! It was such an amazing shot. I mean, of course, I could have probably made a better, more impressive hit. But I hope he finds that box he was looking for in the middle of that party. It might help him if he learns how to do the turnip twist. That would make it a whole lot easier to get through the crowd that way. Dean Wormy and the mayor proceeded to get shit-faced instead of dealing with their responsibilities. Good thing, too, because Dean Wormy's wife was getting cozy with Otta. She's in for a good night. I hear Otta's a fun-sized time. The YPAMPT is taking on trainees at this time. Spot's got an amazing bargain to become a second level thief with training by Ro Minhans. Good luck, Spots! I could really use some of Ophi's cookies right about now. It would be great before I got to sleep. But Ophi is now on the lam. I heard he blinked to Okaz for a place to lie low until the heat is off him. Well, I guess I'll get some sleep if I can't get any of Ophi's cookies. The dream sequences for the night. Chadwick's were exploring the island with his new pirate crew who are knee-deep in octopuses, looking for the town. Snizban is finally licorice root rich, bitch! He meets the goddess Aphrodite, who is not happy he wandered into her vineyard and wanted to make a wine that makes your urine different colors. So she tosses his ass out. But she isn't such a bitch. She did let him have a handful of orgasmic grapes on the way out. Hardcore needs to deliver a rutabaga to Floby. I hope your head feels better. Loretta, Jeff the Monkey, and Danko Sweetleaf, sans Boople Snoot, are being served triple-layered piña coladas and just live their best lives. Evo, the new owner of BCGC's, who has the most fantastic mustache you've ever, has now made the bar topless. Unfortunately, Barry is not about to run around topless. Barry really wants to go backstage, so she offers up three of the blondiest, well-endowed ladies to the bouncer and Evo to get backstage and keep her shirt. This is not going to work for Evo, but he makes her a deal. He hires her to be in charge of the bands, but she needs to wear mustache pasties. Barry can live with that. That is all.